And Maximus Analysis here for February 17th, 2016. And we have for 2016 the first 3-day winning streak. And that could just show you again, that reiterates what I was talking about in regards to the aggressive trading style that needs to be used during these times. The volatility has increased tremendously, which makes moves short and violent, meaning you have to adjust your time frame according to the trading environment. With that being said, we saw a little bit of, again, it was FOMC today, so we saw a little bit of stutter at the 1925 level. Okay, what we want to see overnight for the ES is a hold of the 1914 level, and if they're not going to hold at 1914, we need a hold of the 1903 level. Okay, we're 20 points above 1900, we're 3 days in a row, so what we're looking for now is, again, not to initiate longs now, but to see how the retracement is going to react. Are they going to retrace back into this 1871 level and launch back up? If they get to 1871, I'll be a little bit cautious of going long again, because that would, again, give you a high here and another pivot here lower. But it's more of just saying, listen, we really have to look for ideal situations. Now for the top end side, we're looking at 1936 to 1958 as potential places that they can pause if they pop up for another day. They held this is basically my bear line in the sand. They tapped it and launched off of it, so it's three very, very strong days, but we have to still make sure we are looking at where we are in the trend. Now we see in the past that they've launched, and again, we want to see if they're going to have some type of pullback. We can kind of educate ourselves on the past to say if they're going to have a pullback, we would like something like this, maybe something real tight and tidy in regards to this, and just these two bar pullbacks. We don't want something mirroring this type of pullback to come, because it's not really a pullback, it's more downside. But we'd rather have something, you know, kind of just equate, or trying to quantify what would be a good retracement versus a bad retracement. A good retracement would be a 1-2 small candle day, low volume day retracement versus a complete washout of this day's action and getting back under 1900, 1903 level. So I'm talking a lot regarding the ES, because again, I don't want people to initiate longs now and say, I got, you know, they set me up. It's, again, you could be late. That's fine being late. Just wait for the next setup versus chasing. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to it regarding the NQ. We also have the same type of scenario here where we want them to stay above this 4130 area overnight and continue to the upsides. Again, the volume is tapering off a little bit, but that's fine either way. And we want to see how they're going to react at this 4250 area, 4290, 4300 area as well. Now this is a lot of movement in the last 3 days, and again, if you took it to the upside, congratulations. Again, you can take retracements on both sides with the trend or the counter trend based on previous support and resistance, and you just have to make sure you quantify your stops. The only thing we can trust in this game is the stops. So make sure you define your risk and go accordingly to plan. You see a big day again for the YM. So now they're, you know, bucking up past the previous sell signal, which is around here at the 16,200 level. And we want to see how they react. It might seem far, but it's not in volatile times, how they're going to react at this 16,750 area, and potentially if they get up to the 17,000 area, excuse me, and how we're going to play that. But again, it's not to chase. And a lot of people will see this W, and I say, cool, that's a W that you could work with. But if you're looking for a W, you're looking to anticipate a W. And if you see a W, it's not to get in now, or to get in some type of pullback, because your stop naturally would have to be below here. And that's typically beyond people's threshold. They want to put a stop, and also risk reward. You got to think of, you know, you don't want to do 1-to-1 because you end up churning your account. Even if you're a great trader that has, you know, 60, 70, 80%, which 60% is killer, but the proper type of risk management is what you need to put forth. Let's look at crude. Crude again gave a Didn't even give a signal. They're just hovering into yesterday's price action range. So we'll see if they break above or not. A break above 4250, 4275 would be something that I would, look to see what they're going to do to the upside. They still have lower highs in place. And we want to see what happens when they break a previous low. So again, a break of a previous low puts them back under that 29, 2850 level that we were looking to say maybe they can go test new lows if they break below that. So right now we're kind of in no man's land in regard to a swing trade. Day trading again is a completely different story. Let's look at some names. So one of the biggest names again was Priceline earnings before they opened, which basically rocked them up 9%. So with that being said, we just have to see they're right at the 200-day moving average. If you're gonna play this, again, you have to just define either below this previous pivot or below. Basically, I think you should give it some space and go below here. Again, it might be a little wider stop than you want to, but on gap ups, it's most people are trying to go long on a chase. Just wait and maybe break it down to a lower time frame if you really want to manage your risk accordingly. Baidu actually looks like a short coming up. So again, they could pop this up a little bit more, but again, I want to see how it reacts when it breaks below a previous day's low. You have very small candles, not really giving you much on the volume side. And again, looking at the trend, we don't want to, get blinded by just looking at 1 or 2 days. We want to look at, encompass a couple months, 5, 6 months of data to really look and see how this is going to play out. We have also Netflix, which again gave a really strong move today. But here's what I want to happen. I don't want them to gap down for tomorrow. The reason why is because on an intraday basis, I don't know if this is capitulation or not. So I'd rather see a gap up, and a gap up would probably be faded, but a gap down would definitely show like something's going on. So we'll observe these and see how the ES works right now. ES right now is at 1922, so we'll still see. But for this name, Netflix, we really want to make sure that we're looking at how they're gonna react in the morning. Same thing goes with Google. Google, we want to see how they're looking. Again, this still can look like a very bear flag. It's kind of sloppy price action, but we'll see exactly how they go from here. We also have this prior pivot to the left that I have this arrow on, so we'll look at what happens around the 740 area. Apple, again, it was sideways for such a long time, really not participating in much in this bull move in regard to percentage movements, but we'll see what happens. What is telling? I'll do one more beta name. LinkedIn. Again, LinkedIn is a very difficult chart. Again, I told people, and this is not for me to fortune tell or anything like that rubbish. It's just to say, listen, if you're going to take a short, don't take it after it went in half. It took a haircut of a half. Just wait for a proper setup and go from there versus trying to chase. Now, here's something that I'm kind of looking at, and again. I'm looking at this is Goldman Sachs, and the banks really didn't participate much in today's action. So we want to see if those names gap up a little bit more. We have this is Goldman Sachs. We have JP Morgan here. Again, not really participating much. We have Citigroup here on the daily, not participating much. And we also have Morgan Stanley. So not really giving much. Although those are just small indecision, low volume days. And usually, if we have some real budding rip to the upside type of potential, we kind of really want them to participate a little bit more. So again, that doesn't mean that this is a false rally. This just means to keep your heads up and continue to look at things holistically versus just 1 or 2 bars, 1 or 2 names, the FANG. You want to kind of look at different sectors and say, okay, maybe they're rolling money out of this into consumer goods or one some type of cyclical type of sector. You want to kind of keep those things on your radar. So again, this is a little bit longer than I typically do. I just want to slow down and make sure I deliver some good information for you guys. And let's see what happens tomorrow. Take care.